Hi, my name is Colette, author of Why Yoga, the Art of Centering. Did you know the most effective way to toughen your joints and muscles is called pressure? Why Yoga is about binding your body and putting pressure on your joints and muscles to help heal, cleanse, and toughen your body from the inside out. Come join me every week on my YouTube channel and let's work out together. Please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Let's go ahead and lay on our back facing the wall. You're gonna lay on your back and you're gonna be about a foot away from the wall and put your legs up on the wall. So you have your heels of your feet on the wall and stretch your arms over your head like you're trying to reach the top of your mat. Take a long, steady breath in and just keep reaching your arms up to the top of your mat. Exhale. Inhale again and have your left hand reach the top of your mat. Exhale. Have your right hand reach the top of your mat. Inhale. Exhale. Again, reach both hands to the top of your mat as you inhale. Then exhale, bring your arms around. Wrap your arms around your right leg and tuck your chin in as you try to have your forehead touch your right knee. While you're doing this, you're drawing your shoulders away from your ears and you're tucking your chin in so you can get your forehead to tap your right knee. So you're hugging your right leg. All the air is out. Now lay back down. Take your right foot and tuck it deep into the left side of your leg, right into the lower groin area. Your right foot is tucked in deep. And then once you tuck your right foot in deep, then gently press your right knee with your right hand and open up your right hip. While you're doing this, drop your shoulders down away from your ears. Good. And then put your right foot back on the wall and bring your arms over your head and inhale again. Long, steady breath in. And exhale, bring your arms around and grab your left leg. You're pulling your forehead to your left knee as your forehead is to your left knee, and you draw your shoulders down. You're concentrating from armpit to hip and from scooping your core in and up. So it really has nothing to do about stretching your legs as much as what you're doing in between from your hips to your shoulders. And then lay back down and take your right foot, tuck it deep into the right side. Draw your shoulders away from your ears and press into your left knee. You're trying to relax your body and again, trying to always draw your shoulders away from your ears, because naturally you want to pull your shoulders up to your ears when you're using your arms. And we're going to try to pack them down instead. And just gently press with your left hand onto your left knee. Good. And then bring your left leg back up on the wall. And bring your arm back over your head and take a long, steady breath in. see how much you can separate each rib. If you just think about trying to separate one rib from another, then you just naturally are trying to get as deep of a stretch as possible. And in between each rib are ligaments and tendons.
Thunderbolt, and then stand tall. Root your arms up high. As you inhale, keep extending your arms and stretch. Then bring your hand to your heart. Make sure you're standing on all four corners of your feet and twist your body with your arms up and place them on the wall. Drop your shoulders down. Turn your head, look at your right hand as you reach the crown of your head to the ceiling. Inhaling, exhaling. Bring your hands up high, hands back to your heart, and rotate the opposite direction. As you're standing, you're reaching the crown of your head to the ceiling with your hand pressing into the wall, creating resistance. As you drop your shoulders down, inhale, bring your arm back up, long deep breath in, coming back down to your thunderbolt. Make sure you're planting all four corners of your feet to the ground. Bring your hands to your heart, draw back your shoulder, and then ease your body back down into a deep forward bend. Holding your deep forward bend, tipping the tailbone up to stretch out your back and keep pressing all four corners of your feet to the ground and hold. Inhale up into your flat back and walk your hands back up to the top of your mat. You are now in a downward dog pose, getting a deep stretch between your blades. Pull your tummy in and up and inhale. Balance your body and continue a deep stretch as you're pressing your hands down to tip your tailbone up. Again, long deep breath in, keeping your tummy in and up. Balance yourself on the balls of your feet as you shift your weight to your hips. When you're ready, you can step or jump to your hands. Fold your body back into a deep forward bend. Preparing yourself, your arm to the side as you come back up into your thunderbolt. Reaching your arms up and stretch your arms up to the ceiling again. Just feel like you're lifting the crown of your head right up to the ceiling as you inhale.
And see if you can stretch out the muscles that are attached right at the base of your skull. And if you kind of curl in nice and deep, you can feel if you're tucking your chin in, you're stretching out the right at the attachment of the muscles attached to the neck. And let's do some tapping as you tap your elbow to your knee. As you exhale on 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 2, and 1, and lay back down. Grab your knees, lock your knees left and right. Bring your legs straight up and wrap your arms around your legs again. This time your forehead to your knees. So your feet are going straight up to the ceiling and your arms wrap around your legs, but your forehead is trying to reach. You need to stay there for a second. You can see how you really have to exhale deep to be able to get a good punch. Then grab your right leg, your left leg, I'm sorry, and let your right heel touch the wall. So now you're hugging your left leg, right heel touch the wall. Reverse, grab your right leg and your left heel touch the wall. You're gonna hug that leg in as close as you can get it. Go from left to right, from left
to right, from left, to right, and left, to right. Good, lay back down. Lay all the way down, rock your body left and right. Anytime your neck is bothering you and doing any type of sit-up work, first and foremost, support your head. Support your head. All right, your hands are on the turn of your leg. Your forehead comes back in as you crawl back in, trying to reach your forehead to your knees. Now underneath your fingers and grab right behind your head and support your head is up and tap your elbows to your knees. As you tap your elbows to your knees, bring your knees to your elbows for like a crunch. You bring your knees in and you tap your elbows on 10, 9, 8, 7, sit, then you keep your arms steady and you just let your knees do the work. Your core will be doing the work. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now sit up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Elbows to knees this time. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All the way down. Let's put your feet back on the wall. Let's tuck your elbows to the side of your body. Drawing your shoulders away from your ears and bring your hips back up. Bring your hips nice and high as they grab the side of the mat. And I'm going to put my heels back on the wall. I'm back into an ease plank again. As you're in an ease plank, you're pushing away. Your heels are pushing into the wall. And the wall is pushing back. See if you can get that pressure of the foundation of the wall. And you can squeeze your kneecaps up so that pressure is going right into the fiber of your muscle. If you squeeze and raise up your kneecaps, you're making every muscle, every fiber in your muscle to be activated. Hold that. You'll see how much easier it is, how easy it is to stay afloat like this when you're concentrating on using not just your hips and your butt, but all the muscles in your legs can be involved in this inverted pose. Hold that. That means you have to push away from the wall to really engage into your muscles. Put your feet back on the wall, lower your body back down, and bring your knees back in. Rock your knees up and right. So now you're a good foot away from the wall. Bring your head back up, put your hand behind your head, tuck your elbows to your knees, rock your body left and right a little bit, so that way you can relax your neck muscle. And then have your elbows tap your knees again. And can you have your right foot tap the wall and take your right elbow and tap the outside of your left knee? And then reverse, have your left foot touch the wall and your left elbow touches the outside of your right knee. Meanwhile, you're still tucking your chin in and you get a good deep crunch. Let's go back and forth from right to left. And really, it's all about you keeping yourself tucked in nice and deep. That when we rotate, you're getting a good core engagement here on 8 and 8 and 7 and 7. You want a nice rotation, and you want to support your head so your neck isn't doing anything, and all the activity is done right into the center, right into your core. 3 and 2 and 1, and done. Bring your elbows to the side again, tuck your elbows down, put your feet back up on the wall again, and lift your body back up. Straighten out your legs, you're in a plank again, pressing your heels into the feet. Your legs are straight. You want to feel that pressure in your heels of your feet, going all the way past the ankles, past the calves, up to your lower part of your hamstring, into your knee area, and right up into your hip. Want to really savor that pressure and make sure you're getting it everywhere to tone up every part of your body.
hold that. That means either your kneecaps are up and your quads are engaging. And even the core, even your abdominal are engaging in this pose. Good, bend your knee and come on back down. Let's go ahead and wiggle down a little bit. And rock yourself again, left and right, having your balls of your feet on the wall. So you kind of have your knee bent feet, and you're gonna have the balls of your feet on the wall, and bring your head up, and just look at your knees, and just stay there for a second. Rock your body left and right. So you're in the balls of your feet, and your chin is tucked down, and just get a good stretch here. When you're in this position, you're pulling your tummy in and up, using the whole body. You're able to get the feet clenched. And just again, tap your elbows to your knees. On 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and 2, and 1. Lay back down. Now you're pretty close to the wall. You're about maybe half a foot. With both knees together, you take both knees and put them on the floor to the right. Can you put your feet on the wall with your feet tucked in, where actually your heels and your feet are lined right up with your tailbone? Then once you have your feet tucked in, can you take your arms and stretch them out far? Right arm far to the right, left arm far to the left. So with your feet on the wall and your legs on the floor, you're getting yourself in a real deep low back twist as you press your arm down to the floor, left arm far to the left, right arm far to the right. And so you're really forcing your rotation in your spine. That's what you want. You really want to rotate and twist the spine. Hold that. You can look at your left hand. Good, bring your knees up. Let's do the opposite. Your feet are together, your knees are together. Take both knees down to the left. Tuck your feet in the wall so you're bracing yourself. And then reach your right hand far to the right, left hand far to the left, and look at your right hand. So if your feet tucked in, you're actually putting a lot of pressure into your hips. And that's what we want. We want to go right into the ball in the socket. So you have to push yourself into the wall with your feet and then get a deep twist in your low back. The sacrum and the whole area in the pelvic area are very, very tight joints. They're very tight. And so it takes some serious pressure to make those joints move. Good, bring both legs back up. Let's go ahead and wiggle yourself down a little bit more. Now you're just a few inches from the wall and you bring your legs straight up to the ceiling. So your legs are up on the wall, reaching up to the ceiling, and your hands are at the top of your mat again. You're stretching your hands right up to the top of your mat and just kind of rock your body left and right. You're gonna try to separate each vertebrae in this stretch and hold that. And you wanna try to see if you can keep your legs straight. Try not to bend your knees. And taking your long stretch with your hand to the top of your mat and you're breathing in. Imagine that you're putting on a tight pair of jeans. You're having to really pull that abdomen in and up. Just keep lengthening. Good, and exhale. Bring your hand behind your head and look between your legs and rock yourself left and right. And you're scooping your tummy in. Now take your hand, can you touch the wall? See if you can touch the wall. If you can't, just wiggle yourself in position. Then if you would extend your hand, and if your palm of your hands are on the wall, because you're too close. You want to be just a good distance when you're reaching to tap the wall. And let's do some sit-ups. Back. 10. You're going to tap the wall. You're tapping the wall, your chin is tucked in, your arms are straight. If you extend your body to tap the wall, you're using your arms to your hips on 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and down. Again, if your neck is an issue, then just grab your hand behind your head. We have to protect your neck muscles first and foremost. Your arms are over your head. You're rocking your body left and right. We just tend to wake up all the intricate muscles in your body, the little ones, the ones that are all involved in attaching and keeping your joints together and keeping the mobility. We want to go for those joints, those muscles and tendons, because that's where the change is really to be made, to change your whole body, is going into the fine muscles of your body. Bring your hand behind your head again. Exhale. Tuck your chin in. The legs are wide apart this time. Now put your hand between your legs and poke your tummy in. Just tap as well. Good. 10, 9, 8, 7. You tap, it becomes you tap. You're using your arm to the hip and also scooping below your navel. If your neck bothers you, then hold your head up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and down. Laying back down, tuck your elbows to the side of your body and bring your knees in. Wrap your shoulders away from your ears. So now you're very close to the wall. Rock your body left and right. Just again, with your knees together, put both legs onto the floor. Both knees are on the floor. Your knees are tucked in real tight as your feet are on the wall. Put your hand behind your head this time. Twist your knees down to the ground on the right and look at your left elbow. You want to get into a deeper stretch, going right into your sacrum. And that's pressing your knees down to the ground on the right and pressing your left elbow down on the left is your way of knowing that you're giving yourself the deepest stretch you can give yourself. Good, bring your knees back up. Prepare yourself. Turn your knees now to the left. Lower both knees down to the left. Your feet are on the wall, pushing off to create a deep twist in your low back. Meanwhile, your right elbow is on the floor. And you can try to even look at your right elbow. You can't get in an any deeper twist than where you are right here. Good, bring both legs back up. So you're on your back, your knees are tucked in nice and deep. Now bring your arm to the side of your body and pull your shoulders away from your ears. With your feet on the wall, lift your body back up. Walk your shoulders together. You're having the balls of your feet on the wall, you're in a bridge. That means your knees are bent and your knees are stacking above your shoulders. Can you squeeze your buttock? Can you push away from the wall? Can you feel how that's running right into a very difficult area to go into, is the side of your buttock, right side of your torso. You can feel that area really can use some good engagement there. So just pause there for a second as you try to, as you bring your squeeze into your buttock, you're gonna really work into those muscles all along the hips. From there, go ahead and straighten out your legs again. Now we're in a higher inverted pose here. As you're lifting and pushing off, your legs are straight. The heels of your feet are on the wall and you're pressing into the wall. And it kind of changes the dynamic of where you're putting your pressure. It goes right into the hips again, right into the bottom of the socket, and just stay there for a second. You're really also getting the lymphatic fluid to move. That starts way down at your feet. And by being upside down like this and squeezing your muscles to the bones, you're massaging and getting all that lymphatic fluid moving in your body, cleaning your body and strengthening it. All right, bend your knees, bring your legs back down. Come all the way back down. Rock your body left and right. Tuck your chin in. You have your feet on the wall.
Cradle your head, bring your head up, and tuck your chin in as you cradle your head. Rock your body left and right. Now you can have your elbow tap your knee, or you can have your hand stretch out and touch the wall. But these are more sit up. 15, 15, 14, 14. Tap, 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 tap. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and down. Bring your knees, tuck it in. Draw your shoulders away from your ears, rock your knees left and right. And can you rock yourself right up to the wall, like you're sitting on the wall? Put your leg back up on the wall. Bring your arms over your head and inhale as you stretch. As your arm is stretching over your head and you're taking a long, steady breath in, then bring your arms around, grab your right leg, pull your forehead to your right knee, and if you need to hold your head up, that's fine. Otherwise, grab that right leg and hug it. If you're pulling in, you can feel like you're lifting up your bum bag. So we're kind of going through the back way and toning up into your core. Bring your right foot back on the wall. Bring your arm back over your head and inhale. Bring your arms around, grab your left leg. Exhale all the air out. Forehead to your left knee and hold. You're reaching your forehead to your left knee as you're hugging your leg and pulling it in as much as you can. Good. And back down. Both legs are up on the wall. Your elbows are to the side of your body. Bend your knees where your feet are now on the wall. And you're in a higher bridge. As you walk your shoulder blades together and you're stacking your knees above your shoulders, and your hand can almost touch the wall. This is a beautiful bridge here, and it's just good for that stacking here. It's actually toughening the side of your torso. From there, bring your feet together and take your right foot to the ceiling. Bring your right foot over your head and your left foot, let's go right into a plow. You're going right into a plow. You can put your hands behind your back or just have your hands on the floor. So you pushed off the wall and you were able to just flip your feet right over your head. If that's too hard, then just tuck your knees in and have your knees touch your forehead. You tuck your legs in and just support yourself that way. In this plow, you may want to even have your hands reach over your head and touch your feet. And stretch out your spine. So we're kind of going in the back way and toning up your body nice and quick. So that way you're going to see in your yoga flow how much more flexible you are, how much easier it is to do your yoga flow. Just rock yourself a little left and right when you're upside down like this, or just massage your neck and your shoulders too. Having your feet together, let's take your right foot back up to the ceiling. Put your right foot back on the wall. Bring your left foot up to the ceiling. Bring your left foot back on the wall. You're on the bottom of your feet in this bridge. Bring your hips forward and squeeze into your hips and your thighs again, and just pause for a moment. And just think about what's going on in your abdominals and inside the muscles of your organs. That as you're upside down like this, the blood is just nourishing the internal part of your body too. It's kind of accelerating the blood flow. All right, come all the way down, you're back on your bed. Can you rock your body a little up and right and come away from the wall? So you're going to be about a good couple of feet maybe away from the wall. And bring your knees back in, rock your knees back. Holding on to the shin of your leg, just bring your head back up and exhale one more time into a deep crunch as you try to get your forehead touching you. You can stay like this. You can hold your hand behind your head. Or you can bring your legs straight up to the ceiling. And can you touch your feet? As your legs are pointing up to the ceiling, can you tap your feet? As you reach up and tap, 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 tap. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and 2, and 1, and down. Rock your body left and right. So you have a good couple of feet away from the wall. If you're not, wiggle yourself because we're gonna sit up. And I wanna make sure when we get up, we don't hit your head. All right, so you cross your ankles. Let's just sit, rock yourself and sit right up and you're looking at the wall. Rock yourself a little left and right. You're sitting right on your sit bones. You're looking at the wall, your shoulders away from your ears. And you want to feel like you're sitting on your sit bones. So kind of rock yourself until you feel like you got your tailbone slightly back and your hips forward. Once you have that down in your easy pose, then straighten out your arm behind you, spread your fingers apart, press your fingertips into the earth with your arm perfectly straight, and see if you can reach the crown of your head to the ceiling. See if you can actually feel like you're elevating and stretching and lengthening your spine. Take a long, steady breath in here as you, with your arm, are giving your body your own traction. Breathing in. Once you feel like you have lengthened your body as much as you possibly can, and that includes pulling your tummy in and up, then maintain this height. Put your right hand on the outside of your left knee. Put your left hand behind you, where your left hand is right behind your tailbone, and twist and look over your left shoulder. Now you can look over your left shoulder if you're sitting as tall as you possibly can, and your right arm is perfectly straight, using as a leverage to twist and look over your left shoulder. So everything has to be in place to get that twist. Come on forward, you exhale. Let's inhale, sitting tall again. Take your left arm. Your left arm is going to stretch and push into your right leg. Your right hand is taking the crown of your head to the ceiling and it's pushing you up. As your left arm is twisting and your eyes are open and you're looking over your right shoulder as you breathe in. Can you breathe in and feel that stretch, not in your lower back, but right in the middle of your upper back, your thoracic. Good. Forward. All right, let's go ahead. Wiggle yourself back. I want you to come in all four. Your head facing the wall, you're in all four, and then position yourself to put your thumb and your index finger on the wall, your palm of your hand on the floor, and go right into a downward dog. So with your hands on the wall, the palm of your hand on the floor, your thumb and index finger on the wall, you're pushing yourself away from the wall as you're in your downward dog, and you're taking that force that you're pushing into and you're trying to get it to go all the way up your spine. So that pressure in the wall is being moved and just making the most of all that pressure, because that pressure is gonna toughen up your spine and the bone, the rib cage. As you're in this deep downward dog and you can feel like your ears are coming in front of your arms and you're squatting down, I want you to feel like you could just pull those shoulder blades together, that you are starting to move the muscles in your back. And for many of us, we never really know how to move those muscles, to move those bones. We don't even think they're possible. But here they are. And those muscles are so important because they help you stand upright and tall. So now your ears are in front of your arms, your knees are slightly bent, your feet are apart, and you're pushing away from that wall with your thumb and index finger to be able to pull that gravity
and that pressure in the middle of your back. Good, let's walk your hand to your feet. You're in a deep forward bend here, we're taking a break. Your feet are still width apart, and your feet are facing forward. And then put your hands on your lap, shift back into your hip, as you're stacking your hip above the heel of your feet. And then bring your arm out to the side, but now you're stacking your shoulders above your hips. If you find it hard to do, then open the feet more apart and squat down. Got your arms butt apart, you feel like you're gonna sit down on a chair, your shoulders are rolled back. Can you bring your hand up to the ceiling and in the thunderbolt here, stand up. You inhale, breathing up. And look up. Bring your hand to your heart. Circle your arms again. Stretch them as high as you can. Go right back to the feeling you had before. You want to duplicate that. You want to go back to that same deep stretch. As your hands are up and you feel like you're actually separating one rib from the next as your arms go up. Then bring your hand to your heart, bend your knee back down to your deep chair, put your hand behind your back, and maybe you need to open your feet a little bit more and squat down and stay there for a second. You want to see if you can dig your heels into the earth as you roll back your shoulders. You can't really dig your heels down into the earth if you're leaning forward. You have to pull your shoulders back, bring your blades together, and drop your weight into your hip, which will drop right into the heels of your feet. Hold that. Can you take your right hand and just stretch it forward? Bring your right hand behind your back. Can you bring your left hand and stretch it forward? Bring your left hand behind your back. Make sure you don't buckle your knees in. Make sure that you're bracing yourself in a seated position. Then bring your arms around and stretch your hand up to the ceiling and bring your hand to your heart and come back down into a deep forward bend. Rock yourself and stay in that deep forward bend. Rock yourself, holding yourself in. As you exhale, what you're trying to do is get your tailbone way up. So as you get your tailbone way up and you pull your tummy in up, then you can fold in deeper. You can fold down deeper because you're creating space, the necessary space to fold in. Go into a hard flat back by looking ahead at the wall in a high flat back and an exhale. Back down, folding. As you're folding it, cross your hold on to your elbows with your hands. So your hands are holding on to your elbows as you drop the crown of your head down. You can see how you're even getting a traction here on your spine by just holding on to your elbows. You can feel how you're lengthening your spine. And your feet are wide apart and your weight on the heel of your feet. So that way you can brace yourself to give your upper body a deep stretch. Your body will not go in a stretch if it doesn't feel grounded and secure. Hands back on the mat, you're going into your flat back. Walk your hands back up, put your thumb and index finger back on the wall. Palm down, and here you are back in your downward dog, and maybe you can feel that it's actually better already. You're seeing a difference. As you're in this deep downward dog and you're pressing into the wall, can you rock your hip to the left and feel the stretch running from your right hand to your right hip? And then can you rock your hip to the right and feel the stretch from the left hand to the left hip? Feel that all along the side of your spine? Good, and then come back into the center. rock your hip a little left and right. Really get into the side of your torso here. Just stretch it out. Let's bring your feet together. You're still pressing your hands into the wall, and you're still bringing your ears in front of your arms. You have your feet together, your knees are bent. Can you take your right foot high up to the ceiling? See how high you can get your right leg as you push away from the wall. So the wall makes a big difference in how much stronger your body is. And then bring your right knee to the nose and take your right leg back up to the ceiling. And bring your right knee to the nose. Take your right foot back up to the ceiling. Bring your right knee to the nose. Take your right leg back up to the ceiling. And how high can you reach up your right leg and just kick it up? 1, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And your right foot next to your left foot. Having your feet together, walk your hand to your feet and give your body a break as you fold back down, dropping the crown of your head down. Your feet are hip width apart, the crown of your head is down. You're weighted in the back of your heel. Put your hand on your lap and back in your chair. If you're back in your chair, you're dropping your shoulders down, circle your arms back up to the front of them, and stand up to an extended mountain. Bring your arms and legs up to the ceiling and just keep taking your breath in and up here. If you're constantly trying to see if you can separate one rib from another. So it takes a lot of mental and physical effort to be able to get that sensation and feel how you're lengthening your spine. Bring your hand to your heart and exhale. Circle your arm to the ceiling, deep chair again. Circle your arms around you in a chair, grab your elbows, and have your hand behind your back and your hand grab your elbows. If you're in a deep chair, and if you can't bend your knees nice and deep, then go ahead and open up your feet a little bit more. So now I'm in a deep chair, and I'm holding onto my elbows, and I'm looking up to the ceiling. Stay there and try to see if you can keep your jaw relaxed and breathe in. Then bring your arms around, back up into your thunderbolt. Bring your hand to your heart and exhale. Come back down into a forward bend.
Hold in.
Now, if you were digging your heels down into the earth in that position, then when you come all the way down to your forward bend, it's real easy because you're having good support. Go into a high flat back. With your head, walk your hand back up to the wall. Thumb and index finger back on the wall. Feet together, tailbone up. Ears in front of your arms. Pull your tummy in and up. Feel the back of your blades coming together as you're pushing away from the wall. With your feet together, take your left foot high up to the ceiling. Now, if your right foot is close to your hand, you're not gonna be able to get your left leg high up. So the distance of your right foot to your hand is really important. Bring your left knee to your nose, take your left leg up. On 5, on 4, on 3, and 2. Take that left leg high up and inhale and push away from the wall. Still get your ears in front of your arm. And if you haven't or you can't, then you need to move that right foot further away from your hand. Now kick your left leg on 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 2, and 1. Bring the left foot back down. Can you spread your feet wide apart? Just the big toes are on the edge of your mat. You're in a deep downward dog and squat your knees and feel as you're pushing away from the wall. It's going right up into your arms and right up into your hips. That's really, really good stuff. You are covering every part of your trapezius muscle, all along the side of your rib cage. Everything is being challenged. So your legs are wide apart, your big toes are on your mat.
And then just dig outside. Can you put your left hand in the center of the wall? Can you take your right hand to the ceiling? Then you got a tripod between your left hand and both feet. And then put your right hand down. And put your right hand on the wall and move your left hand up to the ceiling. You pull that. Good. And then go to your right hand. Go ahead, put both hands on the wall, put both feet back into the center of your mat. Bend your knee and lean back into your hips. Fold yourself in, tailbone is up. Feel how those shoulder blades are going back. Even the shoulder blades and the bar of the socket, you know, all of that, you feel strengthened. We're realigning and balancing your body. Walk your hand to your feet for your deep forward bend. Deep forward bend. Drop your head down. Bending your knee deep, go into your deep chair. As you're in your deep chair, you can open your feet apart a little bit. Put your hand behind your back and balance yourself. Draw your shoulders back until your shoulders drop above your hips and your hips above the heels of your feet. However, you have to separate your feet to get that. Good forehead. Bring your arms around into your thunderbolt. Bring your hand to your heart and you exhale. Come all the way back down to the ground, you are exhaling. Go into a high flat back, you are inhaling. This time walk your hand down to your mat, but not on the wall, and step your feet up a little bit. So you're in a downward dog on your mat, nice and centered. And just stay there for a moment and just observing your downward dog. You're gonna see it makes a whole new difference here. With you now having used the wall, you understand when you're pushing your hands into the ground, you're trying to push in, so the pressure will push back. So you're using the force and being able to delegate where you want it to go. So you're in a good deep downward dog. Knees are slightly bent. In this position, can you bring your feet together? Your feet are far from your hands. Can you take your right foot high up to the ceiling as you inhale? Swing your right foot to your hand as you exhale and go into a wide leg stretch. In a wide leg stretch, your toes are in, your heels are out, your legs are apart. And you drop your head down. And I think everybody here had a block. So if you have a block, go ahead and grab a block. So you're upside down here in a deep forward bend. Now, if you find that you just have to bend your knees, then use your block, and you'll find out you don't have to use your knees.
I don't understand.
It's better to have your legs straight and not bend your knees. Because we're trying to stretch into the hamstring. So if you're bending your knees, then you're not stretching into the upper part of your leg. As you're folding into a deep forward bend and you're feeling that stretch going right from your hamstrings right up to your hip joints. And just pause that for a second. You want to make sure the weight is in the heels of your feet too. Because that's the only way you're going to get out of this. So you're digging your weight into the heels of your feet. From this position, as you're digging your heels into get your weight into the heels of your feet, put your hands on your hip, and then begin to come up as you inhale, as you're coming up to a flat back, and then you're standing up. Position yourself here, bring your arms up to the ceiling. As your arms are straight up, and you roll back your shoulder, can you interlace your fingers and put your hand behind your head here? Can you feel like your elbows are going back as you're dropping your blades down and your kneecaps are up and your armpits are down to your hips? And at the same time, you're pulling your pelvic floor up. You're going to need it because your legs are apart. You have to rely more on your pelvic floor to keep you up and lift you up. Bring your hand to the ceiling as you inhale. Bring your arms around, bring your arms behind and have your hands grab your elbows. As you're grabbing your elbows, you're trying to pull your shoulders away from your ears. Stay there for a moment. So your kneecaps are up, your feet are wide apart, your shoulders drop down, you're holding on to your elbows, and look up. Try to relax your throat, relax your face. Then standing upright here again, you just tip your head to the left. While you're tipping your head to the left, can you keep your right shoulder down? Don't let your right shoulder come up. Just tip your head to the right and try to keep the left shoulder down. Then standing up, swooping your arms around, extending your hand back up. When you're scooping, you're coming in and up. The way you do that is you bring your kneecaps up and you pull up in your bundle. You're going to need that to come out of this position. Use the lift of your pelvic floor and the inner side of your leg. Bring your hand to your heart. Put your hand on your hip. Go into your flat back. Keep your chin up. And then fold down. So when I went folding down, it was my whole inside that was going up. Using my body to ease myself back down. Let's go ahead and walk your hand up your mat. You're gonna go on your downward dog facing the top of your mat. Your hand at the top, feet are in the back. Hold that as you inhale. Knees are slightly bent. Tailbone is up. Feel a lot of control here. Holding in this position, take a breath in. And when you're good and ready, you can step or jump to your hands. Fold into a deep forward bend. Knees are bent, circle your arms around in your chair. Ease yourself up, stacking and lifting. In your thunderbolt, stand up to an extended mountain. Bring your hand to your heart. Inhale, extended mountain and deep chair. Exhale and forward bend. Inhale into your flat back. Exhale into your plank. Keeping your body afloat just like you were on the wall with a plank. An inverted plank, it's the same thing. Every part of your muscles are working to hold your body into a plank. Then chaturanga. Then inhale for your cobra, your upward dog. Keep your jaw and your throat relaxed. Keep dropping your shoulders away from your ears. When you're done inhaling, then exhale your downward dog. Your feet together, your right foot to the ceiling, inhale high up. Bring your right foot to your hands and prepare for your lunge. As you exhale, you start to come up, and then when your arms go up, you inhale. Inhale, arms nice and high, bend your feet, and exhale to your heart. Keep exhaling, your hands are back down, your right foot is back in your plank. You're still exhaling into your chaturanga. Then inhale, back into your upward dog. Keep your jaw and your throat relaxed. You're in the heels of your hand and you exhale for your downward dog. In your downward dog, your tailbone is up. And you're pulling your tummy in and up. As your ears are in front of your arms, take your left leg up. Begin to inhale here again. And when you're getting ready, left foot to your hand, you exhale. Keep exhaling. You start to come up. And then you inhale when your arms start to come up. So you kind of pause
And you know right when you're going from exhale to inhale, and you use your arm to get your body all the way up. Bring your hand to your heart, exhale. From there, come all the way down.
Take your left leg back and your plank from our exhale and keep your hips up. And then finish up to chaturanga. Roll your shoulders back, lift your body up. Drop your shoulders down. Keep your jaw relaxed. Look up.
In this position, can you turn your head and look at your leg forward? Exhale. Then look back up. And turn and look at your left foot. Exhale. And look back up and prepare yourself for your downward dog.
Deep downward dog. Lean back into your hips. Drop. You're trying to lean back and you feel the weight into the balls of your feet. Feel the weight. That's a way of you knowing that you are really using your lower part of your body to strengthen your body to move into a deep stretch. As you're in this pose and you're breathing in, can you walk your hands to your feet for 3 steps in a forward bend? You're folding into a deep forward bend. And when you're good and ready, come on up and back down.
Exhale, you're coming up. And then inhale, your arms up. Into your heart. While we're here, let's do one last good stretch as your feet are apart. Roll your shoulders back. Keep your feet forward. Right. When you twist to the right, can you drop your shoulders down as you reach the crown of your head up? You're pivoting your spine. You don't want to lean forward. You're trying to draw your shoulders back. Come forward, inhale up. Exhale, your hand to your heart. Fold for the left. You exhale and you're trying to stay as tall as you can. As you pull your arm down to your hip and look to the left. You might find you're really flexible right now. Bring your arm back up, bend your knee, bring your hand to your heart, you exhale. Come all the way down into a deep forward bend, and then exhale. Come up for a high flat back, you are inhaling. Walk your hand up to the top of your mat as you're in a deep downward dog, you are exhaling. Lean back into the balls of your feet, tailbone is up, you are inhaling. And when you're inhaling here, pull your bum back, your pelvic floor up. Holding into this position, take another breath in. In, out. And in, bring your feet together. Bend your knees deep. And when you're ready to exhale, you can step or jump to your hands. Exhaling into your forward bend. Let's go ahead and wrap your arms around your legs, fold in. Trying to pull your chest to your knees. As your knees are bent, put your hand on your lap in your deep chair and shift your weight back. Bring your arms up, your thunderbolt, look up. Hold back, keep your throat open. Don't tense up your throat, even though you're locking your body in. You don't lock your throat, you keep it open. Extend it out and out. Breath in and out. Exhale your hand to your heart. Inhale, extended mountain. And mountain. Thank you.